Hey guys, welcome back. I'm glad to see you came back. Today, I wanted to kind of do a rundown. I'm not sure, but we're going to go through some of my favorite palettes that I've either discovered this year, that came out this year, the ones that I've been loving and I keep coming back to. So, if you're interested in knowing what my favorite palettes are, maybe getting a few favorites of your own, just keep on watching. Okay guys, so I didn't really branch out to a lot of brands this year. I found a few that I absolutely fell in love with and I kind of stuck with them. The stuff that I do have, I like to share with you guys. That way we can, you know, give money to the little guy. Now some of them are more well known and don't come for me in the comments, but I do have a few favorites from canceled or drama riddled YouTubers, but I'm gonna go ahead and we'll start off slow, we'll start off easy, we'll start off drama free. So my first ones, I'm gonna kind of count these as one palette or a set of palettes. So first off, I want to talk about Juvia's Place. Okay guys, they have these beautiful, this is one of the newer ones. This is their sweet pinks. Oh my god, these colors are absolutely stunning. Now granted, with six shadows and all one color story, it's kind of hard to make different looks, but these palettes work so well together with the pinks. I got the violets. Absolutely stunning. Also a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful palette. Now, this one I have used more than I think any of the little palettes I've gotten from Juvia's Place. And I use it mainly for these two shades and the shimmers. These ones come off a little dark on me, but I have posted a few Instagram looks using this palette. It's really easy to throw together a very elegant look with these colors here. And finally, for this little collection or bunch, would be their berries. Now this one and the sweet pinks, oh my gosh, chef's kiss. Great for spotlights, great for smoky eye, great for a cut crease, just really good all around palettes. So that would be my first love of the year, the Juvia's Place minis. I found Juvia's Place through their Masquerade mini palette and I had done a couple extreme makeup or special effects makeup looks with those palettes. Absolutely love them, but the minis, the little palettes, oh my gosh, it's so good. The next one is Color Rain. Now I have their Vivid Pigment palette and I did get that earlier this year, but I know that has been out for a while. This one came out this year. I didn't get it until about midway through the year, but these colors and the looks you can create. You've got some neutrals, you've got the pinks, and I live for a pink eyeshadow moment. I truly do. And then you have these gorgeous, like this is a blue, like duochrome shimmer. You've got a gorgeous white, and then you've got some like green blues, almost turquoise. Such beautiful color combos you can do with this one. Great for summer, great for spring. Their formula is so pigmented. And of course, this is a pressed pigment and shadow palette. What drew me in. And they did have this in two ways. They had it split into a 9-pan and do a 2-pager. And then they had the big flat lay. And I was more for the flat lay just because it's easier to travel with. If I'm going to do people's makeup, I can just fold this back and go for it. Or I can dip into my color and then look at my mirror and apply the color. That's kind of why I like the setup of this one. Next, we have Beauty Bay and Nikki Tutorials. Absolutely love the outside packaging of here. It's supposed to represent the two sides of Nikki. So if you open up the pink side, you've got the brights. You've got these gorgeous shimmers that are just, look at those glisten. and you've got, you know, a dusty rose, a hot pink, a neon yellow, and like an orange, we got a periwinkle blue. But if you look at the other side, you get these dark neutrals, and you can make such beautiful grungy looks. You could do beautiful bright looks, and it's so pigmented, and these eyeshadows are like jelly, creamy, putty eyeshadows. Like, oh my gosh, so beautiful, so pigmented, just gorgeous, glittery shades. And I really enjoyed doing a couple looks with this palette and just kind of showing the versatility of it. I mean, gosh, look at those. If you get it just for the shimmers alone, oh my gosh. But it's a beautiful palette. It performs well, pigmented, colorful. Could be every day, could be special occasion. You could really do a lot with this one. And I think Nikki and Beauty Bay hit it out of the park with this one. So this one made it into my favorites for 2020. It was kind of towards the end of the year, but I really did enjoy it. And I don't know why I'm pulling it out of the cover. I wanted to show you the cover. This one is by Manny MUA, or Lunar Beauty. This is the Moon Spell palette. Now, I did get his Strawberry Dream palette, and I absolutely love that palette. But I didn't get it and play with it as much as I did this one. Moon Spell, I love this. It's made to look like a book. You can set this out and have it just artsy, gorgeous. You pull it out and look at all of this artwork. Just absolutely stunning. Very Manny, very witchy, magical, eclipse, lunar beauty. On the back, you have some more artwork, and you've got some star patterns here. You've got the gorgeous hands, and of course, where to find Manny on the back. It looks as though it's got a little clasp. The golden pages. Packaging is A1. Fabulous. And he never disappoints. I can't wait to get his Lunar Eclipse palette. So you open this one up and bam. You've got some beautiful mossy greens. You've got some neutrals. And then he threw the purples in there. I am a sucker for pink and purple and berry and raspberry burgundy gorgeousness. I am a sucker for it. And with this one, you can do green, you can do neutral, you can do purple. And he has it organized as such. And even if you go this way, you could make a beautiful look. Piper, Sarah, and Bonnie. Or just Winifred with a shimmer. Beautiful. Paige and Nancy, that turquoise. Oh my God, so beautiful. I've done a lot with this one as well. You can see where I've dug into some of the shimmers. Oh my gosh, I absolutely love this. Knocked it out of the park, chef's kiss, all those wonderful things. I just absolutely love this, and I'm glad to have it in my collection. The list is going to be a little controversial. Do not cancel me before I've even started. I'm not famous. I'm not into beauty for the drama. I'm not. I'm into it for the products, for the excitement, for all of that just glam, fun, fabulous, empowering, just wonderful stuff. So with that said, I have three more palettes that I absolutely love. And we have Bloodlust, which is absolutely stunning, absolutely stunning. Packaging, we won't even have to talk about her. And it's purple. It's purple. I don't necessarily understand the pop of red. This teal kind of goes with everything. The turquoise really complements the purples. I don't really use the red. This black I have used in so many makeup looks, even if it's not with this palette. I've done some really, really beautiful looks that I'm really proud of with this palette. Pigmented, blendable, just gorgeous colors. Typical Jeffree Star, great with the formula, and the packaging is just over the top, just gorgeous, 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 with the velvet and the extraness. So there's number one of Mr. Jeffree's on my list. Number two, this one was extremely controversial, And it was the beginning of the end for Mr. Jeffrey when it came to the drama situation. But I do have to rank it, guys. I love a smoky eye. I love black and white shadows. I love being able to contour a face with an eyeshadow palette and just digging on in there. I also love that this folds easily for artsy and artist out there. And it is the cremated palette. I know a lot of people weren't crazy about the color story, the time that it launched, or any of that, but I have used so much of this palette. Like, I have dug into this one. And these colors have always come in handy, whether or not I'm doing a black and white look, or anything like that. I can grab, you know, Last Respects, or The Morgue, or Obituary, and just blend out the edges of an eyeshadow that's not really blending the greatest, even if it is by another company. And a black smoky eye is a wonderful glam go-to. So this one has definitely made it to the top of my Jeffree Star pile. Let's see. Little ASMR. Taking that off there. Is the Blood Money palette. Now this did launch after he was canceled. I don't believe in cancel culture. It's hurtful, it's nasty, it gets really bad. And it's just kind of unneeded. If you don't like them, if you don't follow them, if you don't want to see them, don't look, don't click, don't watch, don't follow. But his formula proves to be amazing every time, and the packaging is always over the top. So we're back to the trunk, and I do own Blue Blood and Blood Sugar, and I bought those last year. But these colors here, the shimmers, I've done a lot with these. I did a lot of my Christmas looks with this palette. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous with the gold, the greens. This black is something else. Just absolutely stunning. You can go mossy green, you can go teal, you could even go kind of blue with some of the colors. Just absolutely all in all a wonderful palette. And he did sprinkle in some neutrals. Yeah, this like peachy tan, you've got a light brown, a greeny tan color. This is a beautiful deep brown, buttery shade. You've got some duochromes in there. Just absolutely stunning, guys. Absolutely stunning. I can't get over it. Every time I swatch this, I want to play. I want to get in there. And I can't do a ranking or the best of without putting one of my new favorites. Past the drama, we got past the canceled people. So we're gonna move forward. There is a collection by this brand I am hoping to get. I am hoping and praying, fingers crossed, I can get the collection. What they did this year was absolutely amazing. But the brand I'm talking about is Melt Cosmetics. And I know this may not have come out this year, but I have discovered Melt eyeshadows this year. Absolutely stunning. I have used this palette for so many looks. Neutral, deep and smoky, grungy gorgeousness. And this is the Rust palette by Melt. If you need any neutral colors, they're there. They're there. You've got white, you've got peach, yellow, tan, deep, gorgeous, chocolatey browns. And this looks a black, but it's a deep, 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 dark brown. And it is absolutely freaking stunning. Now that I have is also from Melt. And it is their She's and Parties palette. And if you love purple, this is a dream. I remember buying the Maybelline palette that had what looked like these colors in here. It was like the Roses palette, and I thought I was hot to trot. It was the best eyeshadow formula I had ever tried. I was wrong. I have never tried eyeshadows like these. They come out so pigmented right at the start. It's done with. So tread lightly, but look at those colors. This is an off-white. You've got a duochrome, a powder purple, almost a dusty pastel lavender. It's coming off a lot more white on camera. There we go. And then you have a deeper lavender. You have like a burgundy berry set of shimmers, this deep, gorgeous grape color. And then this one is the darkest in the palette, and it actually has a little bit of shimmer in it. It's absolutely stunning. Absolutely stunning. Before I wrap this up, this last one, I was almost not going to put it in a 2020 favorite video, only because I haven't had it for very long, but in the month and a half that I had it, I probably did 17 looks with it. And I absolutely love it. It is the Morte palette from Melt. I did get Vita, but I just got her right before Christmas, so I can't really count that as a favorite, even though I have used it a couple times. It's definitely going to end up in a favorites of 2021 for sure. But this color story just speaks to me. It just does. You've got the berry, the cranberries. You've got the deep royal blues going into teal. It's absolutely stunning. If you're interested in seeing any of the looks that I've done, they are tagged in the photos on my IG. I'll put that on the screen here. I would love a follow, especially if you're a fellow makeup enthusiast. And this shade right here, I used to create this outside. Gorgeous. And I used Vita on the edges. I used the yellow and the orange in Vita to create that. But all of this smoky goodness, all this deep, luscious color is one of Melt's shadows, their Beetlejuice collection. I can't wait until I can get my hands on those palettes. Ooh, it's going to be an amazing day. But that's all for right now, guys. Let me know in the comments if you want to see like favorites that I discovered over 2020, or favorite brands of 2020, or just favorites and brands that I love and that I've used. It doesn't have to be in 2020. I have discovered a lot this year, and I've gotten a lot better with my craft and playing around on TikTok, and I've learned to wear lashes, which is so nice, and it makes me feel so beautiful, even if I don't have a full face of makeup on, just to throw on a pair of lashes. But I hope this was helpful to some of you, maybe got you interested in a new eyeshadow palette, or a new color story, maybe got you some inspo. It may be hard to watch for some of you, because I do stan Jeffree Star. I stan his products, not necessarily his drama or the racism or any of that, but I do stan his products, and they are amazing. And just want to throw out there to the universe, I would love to collab with one of these brands in the future. So fingers crossed, maybe after I get famous, there might be a collab in my future. But that's it for today, guys. I love you. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys. Cause you know that, baby, I got biggest fan. I follow your interest. You know me. Papa, paparazzi. Baby, that's a wild superstar. You know that I'm me. Papa, paparazzi. Promise I'll be. But I won't stop until that boy is mine. Baby, you'll be famous. Chase you down until you love me. Papa, paparazzi.